Hi, it's Mike Del Signore. In today's video, I want to talk about what happens if you're arrested by the Lakeville Police Department and are arrested for OUI. Cases brought by the Lakeville Police Department will be heard in the Wareham District Court. Lakeville generally has some video showing how you appeared. I've had cases with this police department over the years, and I can tell you that what you can expect with an OUI case is that while it was easy to get arrested, it's hard to prove these cases beyond a reasonable doubt. There's a very high standard of proof that the government needs to meet. They need to prove the case to an abiding conviction to a near moral certitude. So don't be discouraged if you were arrested. Don't think that's the end of the world and don't think you can't beat the case. These are winnable cases. I win these cases every day in court. Here's some of the things that I look for. So first thing I'll go over and discuss with you is, what was the driving that led to the police stopping you? If the driving was relatively minor, that's the best type of case. In other words, if we could say you pulled over for a headlight, minor speeding, one or two lane violations, we can basically say that your driving is not indicative of somebody impaired, and that if you were impaired by alcohol, your driving would have been much worse. Maybe you would have crashed. Maybe the public would have called in on you. So we're hoping to minimize the driving. Next, we look at how you interacted with the officer. How did you provide your license, registration, things like that? Because the officers are taught in their police training that how somebody provides their license and registration can be a clue or indicator if they're under the influence of alcohol. So we want to try to minimize these clues from the police training, and we want to use them affirmatively. Basically, we want to say, hey, officer, you're taught at the academy somebody impaired may have trouble retrieving their license, registration, may have issues with dexterity getting out of the car. My client didn't. That's inconsistent with your trainings, inconsistent with the argument that this person is impaired. So to the extent we can do that as much as possible, it helps move us towards reasonable doubt. Because these cases basically are judged based on the totality of the circumstances, essentially. You could have a case with bad driving and still be found not guilty. You just, in that case, you'll want to create reasonable doubt from the field sobriety test, the initial interactions, and the booking. So we're trying to find our strongest areas, focus on those, minimize the weak areas or areas that might show impairment. Now, in some cases, there might not be many signs of impairment, and that's a strong case for trial, for sure. These trials can be with a judge or jury. I know the judges very well in Wareham, been practicing there for a long time, so I'll be able to advise you whether you're better off with a judge hearing the case or with a jury. It's a jury, it's six people. The verdict has to be unanimous. So field sobriety tests, like the 9-step walk and turn, one leg stand test, these tests aren't necessarily reliable. There's a lot of reasons why. Maybe your balance wasn't perfect other than alcohol. So the fact that you might not have balanced for the full amount of time doesn't mean you're impaired. In fact, I had a case from Wareham Court where the officer stopped my client before the test was even over, so they finished. And the judge noted that, said, you know, geez, the officer stopped the person from continuing with the test. So these videos do sometimes provide helpful information. I was reading a report today on the one leg stand and watching the video, comparing the two. The video, my client had his foot up for 25 seconds. The report, no indication of how long my client had his foot up. So these videos can be helpful. Certainly they can tell a different story than the police report. So someone who's polite, cooperative, respectful, those are all things that go towards reasonable doubt. If you took a breath test, there are ways to get it excluded from evidence, so don't assume you can't win the case. Now, one of the things people wonder, you're immediately arrested, you want to know when can you get your license back. If you failed the breathalyzer, it's a 30-day suspension. Common mistake, people think it's suspended until the case is over. That's not true. You can get your full license back in 30 days. If you refused, it's a 6-month suspension. This is not a great way to get your license back. The only way is really a not guilty plea prior to the 6 months and ask the judge to reinstate your license. Don't try appealing the refusal. RMV will take out an immediate threat suspension. So if in a refusal case, you're only gonna get back on the road if you wanna admit to the OUI and you can get a letter from your work and get approved for a hardship. Those are things if you don't have a letter from work or if the case is such that maybe the RMB won't grant you a hardship, then you're gonna be stuck, and the best way will be to be found not guilty, ask the judge to reinstate. Now, these are things I go over with people every day. My name is Mike Del Signore. I handle OUI cases in Wareham. Be happy to help you. I've done a lot of cases with the Lakeville Police Department. Call, text anytime at 781-686-5924. I'm here to help.